The thoughts, views, and opinions expressed by its host and guest on this podcast is for entertainment purposes only. I express firmly I am here to have a fun time and don't need anyone ruining it by being butthurt. Take your clapped cheeks somewhere else. I am not a professional. I just play one on the show. Thank you and continue supporting. Deuces.
Welcome to This Is a Musical About Nothing. This is a spoiler alert for people that want to go watch The Joker 2. It is mostly become a murderer and still have love. It's a work in progress, people. All right. Now, if you need me to make you a beat that you can't find the pocket for, I got you too. Something like, yeah, if you need something like that, holla at your boy. But without further ado, you know what I noticed that I didn't do in my last episode? I did not hit any of my drops at all. I don't know. That was kind of weird on my end. So without further ado, let me go in.
Hey, want to hear the most annoying sound in the world?
You're listening to
No
Special
Characters.
Welcome, beautiful people. And I'm going to hit this one, too.
Welcome back to another late night with...
Jose.
That's me. I am your host.
On my phone, anyway, Jay.
That's I. What's up, people? What's going on? And if you don't cut the bullshit, I'm a little... electrically. All right. We're fucking around today. That's what we do. We're fucking around. Okay. Just want to know, microphone. It is 2 o'clock in the morning. The microphone wants to fuck around with me. So, thanks. Doing great. Good. Fucking replace this shit so fast. What's up, people? How you doing out there? Hopefully, you guys are doing great. Hopefully, things are going your way. Hopefully, it is a great, marvelous day for you. As I stated, I am your host.
On my cool, Jay.
And I'm doing pretty good. Even though it's late, I got a little bit of a late start today. A really late start today. I'm lying to you. It's 2:43 in the morning. If you are awake at this time, you know what it's like. You're a night owl. Sometimes you are tired, but sometimes when you try to go to sleep early, it's just not going to be achievable. Happens to the best of us. So, yeah, man. Let me see what I got on my docket. Let's see what I got on my docket. Oh. I guess this is a follow-up from last week's show. So the follow-up from last week's show was, I remember I mentioned the coworker that I work with that I was talking to. And just my luck, the day that I drop the damn episode, I get a notification. And the notification is...
Fuck to and spit on that thing.
If only. The notification was like, hey, you just got a new subscriber on YouTube. And I'm like, great, this is working. Oh, guys, you know what? Before I get there, this is for... The YouTube numbers are finally going up. All it took was me cutting out my favorite section. Darned if you do, darned if you don't. But That's exactly what happened. They somehow unleashed people, well, unleashed my videos to be seen by more people in the public. So I used to stalemate like around like 20, 23 people to view. It's still a good number. It's somebody that's watching. That's the way I see it. People are watching. Now we're in the like 60s and 70s on YouTube, and I'm totally fine with that. As long as that number keeps going up, I feel that we're in a great direction. We're doing pretty good out here. So, yeah, I just wanted to say that. A lot of people would like to be like, oh, you know, that's all you got. I'm like, yeah, that's totally fine. It's the fact that people are sticking around to watch something. That's what makes it amazing, is that people are interested in what I'm saying. So a win is a win is a win is a win. But back to me catching an L, though. So I don't know why this happens, or why is my karma always like this, but it tends to always end up like this. I'll do something and it'll come back to kick me right in the ass. So new subscriber. I'm like, yay, where is it? I'm like it's going up, more subscribers. That's what I need, because the views are good, but I need people to stay and subscribe. So I was like, all right, let's see who it is. And then I see her name. I was like, oh shit, this is gonna be a problem. Shit. I'm like, let's see if she makes it past the first 10 minutes. Because me bringing her up was kind of at the 30, 40 minute point. So I was like, let's see if she does 30, 40 minutes. She did the whole 30, 40 minutes. After the 30, 40 minutes, when it hits the part where I start talking about her, I get the bing. I was like, shit, it's a text message. You feel comfortable talking about me on this show? Yeah, totally do. So were you ever going to mention you bringing me up on the show? No, I didn't think you would be interested in that. So you're okay making fun of us on the show? I'm like, I'm not making fun of us. I'm more making fun of myself. And you just happened to be in the room. She's like, no. You were telling these people that you are flagging the emails because of where I'm from. Yeah. I'm not getting where the miscommunication is. Like, is this what's really happening in real life? Yeah. So I'm basically documenting the people. This is like my autobiography with a little, I don't know what to add there, but this is what it is. In the beginning, I'm basically talking about myself. She was like, yeah, I'm going to need you to stop. I was like, see, I'm going to hold you to these words, because if this thing happens to go to a bigger, or like the next step, I won't be sharing you on my social media, because you requested for that. So, yeah. So, unless you're gonna go and
puck to and spit on that thing,
you're gonna have to wait for this part.
I love you.
You're gonna have to wait.
I wanna take you away from all of this.
I mean, it is what it is. I can't take you away from all of this, because technically you're higher up. You would have to take me away from all of this. No, that doesn't sound right. I'm going to stop fucking with that. Also, because this is close to the microphone, it's giving off an electric magnetic field. So I'm going to just, God damn, that shit's strong. I'm going to disconnect that. Yeah. But it was just so funny. I was like, great. So that wasn't the first time I got egg on my face this week. So it was that. And the very next thing that popped up in the conversation was I made an Instagram story post, right? So the Instagram story post was not supposed to get the traction that it got, but it got traction. It was pretty fucking weird. So what happened was I was scrolling through Instagram, like, dun, 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 and I'm like, oh, that's cool, that's cool, that's cool, that's cool. So this sweater shows up on my Instagram feed, and I'm like, oh, that's fire. I like that. And it was nothing crazy. It was just a blue sweater with two ratchets and some 3M tape on it. I was like, that looks cool. I like that. It wasn't until I went to the next slide that I saw the full message of this shirt, which had nothing to do with the two ratchets in the back. Nothing to do. So it said, fuck. Can I say that? Should I bleep that? Is YouTube trying to come at me for this? Because it said that on the sweater. I was like, oh, I can't wear that. I can't wear that at all. Because I don't know what a Zionist is. The most I've ever heard was Zion, and that's the place that Damian Marlin was always trying to go to. So I'm like, you know what? Let me look it up. Like, what is a Zionist? Because I don't know what a Zionist is. That's hilarious. Well, I can't say that because I don't know the context of what that is. I saw something else. I saw a dog with a mullet. Zionist meaning. A supporter of Zion. You motherfuckers. I don't know what that means. That's like, explain the word road. Well, when she rode her horse down the road and rode it well, like, wait, what? Yeah. A person who believes in the development and protection of a Jewish nation and what is now Israel. Isn't that just called being Jewish? His artist's parents were committed to Zionists. Were committed to Zionists. So does that just a religion? Relating to advocating for Zionism, mainstreaming Zionism. God, that's not the proper like thing. What is a Zionist in civil terms? Thank you. The pursuit of independent Jewish state. Okay. All right. So his shirt said bleep, bleep. And I'm like, oh, I can't wear that. Mostly because of where I work. You're going to be like, you work in a highly Jewish area? Well, it used to be called Long Island Jewish. So me just wearing that shirt willy-nilly is pretty sure going to get me fired. Which would kind of feed fuel to their flame. Because why would you fire it? Because of my shirt. What does your shirt say? Blank, blank. Oh. So they do control the medium. So shit. Let me see. And I'm back. So, yeah. So I made a post, and the post was like, "Yo, I was like, you gotta be careful when you're trying to support your friends, because sometimes you can't be on the same playing level or on the same field because it could come back to kick you in the ass." And it was like, yeah, you were trying to do something because, oh, that's my people's. I was like, oh, no. And then, like, the small print was like, 100% of the funds would go to a person of Palestine fighting against Zionism. And I'm like, is that, like, a clever way to write that the money's going in your pocket? I'm like, sir, I don't think that aligns with the shit that you were saying. So I make this post, and I didn't violate. I didn't say anything that was like, I didn't say anything disparaging against his clothing line. I said it looked good. It looked cool. It looked like it was this. And I was like, but I can't buy it because of what the message stands for. I'm like, I could support you from afar, sir. Because what you're doing is a lot. And he was doing a lot. Like, he really went to a protest with that shirt. I guess that's where you want to wear the shirt out, against the people, so the people that you're protesting against can see it. But he was out there, he was going crazy. And I was like, all right, yo, man, you got your beliefs. And that's cool that you're following your beliefs. But I was like, what you can't do is try to get me to join your beliefs as well so I can end up on an FBI watch list. I can't do that. I'm sorry. I'm already brown, all right? I don't need to be more than what I am unless it's in a positive light. But it was just very entertaining because he reaches out and he was like, hey, man, I don't appreciate the post that you made. I was like, really? I don't appreciate that you try to set me up. I don't appreciate that you tried to use mechanic tools to get the eyes of people in the car community. And this has nothing to do with cars. We need to keep on moving. We need to get on the road to Zion. I guess that does mean like a car, but still, no. I lost in translation in that portion. But it was like, hey, man, you're going to do whatever you're going to do. Shout outs to you. As I preach at the end of the show, if you got to go, set a goal, go for the goal. If you don't reach your goal, get your ass back up. Do it again. And clearly, he's doing what his goals are. He's trying to hit his goals. He's selling clothes. He's trying to get a message out. And then it's like, oh, shit. Go you? I don't know if that's the right thing to say. Go you. So yeah, it was pretty crazy. Pretty crazy. The other thing that happened to me was so I have to explain the morning before I can explain the end, if that makes any sense. Does that make any sense to you guys? That I gotta go fully into what happened before I could really explain what happened. So my morning starts with, I got a package. All right. Got a package. And I had to, I had a package. It was basically my medical supplies. So basically what they happened was I ordered a bunch of like needle tips, right? For my lancet. If you guys don't know what a lancet is, it's a little tool that diabetics carry around that pricks their fingers. It's a finger pricker, right? It's the needle for the finger pricker. So I had to go to the pharmacy that I go to. So I could be like, oh, look, these lancets are incorrect for this. These needles are incorrect for the lancet that I have. So just in case you want to see, here you go. First view. Right here, lancet. You guys sent me about 3 month supplies. That's over 100 needles. I don't know. I didn't feel I needed 100 needles. But I had to take care of this. Now, your boy was driving. And what had happened was I got involved into something that had nothing to do with me. But I was, what's the word I want to use? There's a word for it. I'm blanking out because it's late. But I was basically misidentified and I was accused of doing something that I wasn't doing. And it got me mad because of the way my car looks. See, my car looks like every young kid that would drive it, because they want to pretend it's fast, but it's not really fast. But it has a little snazzy look to it, so they could, if they look the part, they could possibly think that they are the part. That's the car that I drive. So this takes place. I feel like I'm missing steps. All right, so, oh yeah, all right, I properly explained that. So I'm on my way to the place to exchange either the lancet or the needles. Whichever one was going to work is what I was going to do. So the one time I don't decide to speed, drive the normal speed limit, just be a regular law-abiding citizen, is the day I get involved in some bullshit. So what happened was, if you're familiar with the northern state, I mean, if you're familiar with the Grand Central that turns into the Northern State, to get past the Cross Island, the road splits into three. Two to the left, one to the right. And if you're smart, the one to the right turns into two, which takes you back to the road that you were originally on, which was the Grand Central. It's a little shortcut. Probably gave it away, or you probably know about it. You're probably like, hey, man, why you do that for? It's because there's a purpose to it. So I'm driving. I'm going 50, literally going 50 in the right lane. Shit. And then this Nissan Altima just darts right next to me. So I was going to let him. I was like, all right, whatever. We can get in, blah, blah, blah. Because I already see that my road is open. For whatever reason, he decides to slow down. Car hits him. I'm like, shit, it's a car accident. Right? He's like, oh, shit, I just witnessed a car accident. No, I did not. What I was witnessing was road rage. Because this Toyota Camry hit the car, stopped, assessed it, revved it, hit him again, and then they just started taking off chasing each other. Now, I just told you an accident just occurred to the left of me, and I'm like, all right, I'm going to stay the fuck out of it because you're not going to hit my car and involve me in whatever shenanigans you're in. But for whatever reason, the silver Honda Civic that was behind me, I stopped, let them go do what they're doing. I stopped and let them do what they're doing, which means the Honda Civic behind me had to stop too and let them do what they're doing. So out of nowhere, because the accident was isolated, it was just between those two, the Honda Civic decides to chase down the two cars. So now I'm watching a whole fucking movie. I'm watching Speed 4. Shit. Get my ass to work. But I'm watching this all unfold, and I'm like, okay. Now, I don't know what the Altima driver did to piss that guy off that much. But whatever it was enough for him to damage his own personal property and still continue to follow him and damage his property somewhere. When I say he was trying to pit maneuver him, I'm like, yo, you do not know what's going on. But as I stated, we don't know what's going on. What the fuck triggered that response for this person to be like, all right, yo, man, I'm going to fucking jail. So what happens is they take off. I let them take off, blah, 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 blah. I know for a fact, exit 25, there's always a police officer there. Always a police officer there. Now, they take off. The Civic chases after the car, blah, blah, blah. It was weird, bro. He just decided to input himself for no reason. He was literally behind me minding his own business, and then it took off to chase that person. So I'm like, okay. Now I'm driving by the exit because everybody just left me. I'm like, okay, I'm straight. Driving, speed limit still, chilling. I look a little further out. I see the Altima telling the officer what's happening. You could tell he's like frantic. He's like, look. He's just doing a whole bunch of hand gestures because I can't hear him because I'm inside my car and I'm more than like a couple hundred yards away. So I keep going. I'm like, okay, I'm fine. But then I see this. I'm like, what is he pointing at? Like, what is he pointing at? Dude just went like this. I'm like, I don't know what's going on, but okay. So, driving, and I'm like, all right. Then I heard whoop, whoop. I was like, shit. What'd I do? Finally get pulled over. When I finally pull over, and I'm like, hey, officer, what's going on? I'm like on my way to the pharmacy. But as TikTok's, what are they called? auditors will tell you, like, you don't got to answer that shit. Did you pull me over for a reason? All right, don't worry about where I'm going. All right, stick to the reason. Give me my ticket or let me fucking go. Am I being detained? Am I being detained? My taxes pay your salary, asshole. I love when they say that shit. I'd be like, oh my God, that was anybody else. They would have been fucking tased and shot already. But nah, certain people can get away with saying that shit. So I get pulled over. I'm like, what's up? He was like, were you part of this? I was like, no. Well, they're saying you're part of it. No, I'm not part of it. Well, we're going to have to detain you for a bit. I didn't appreciate that. That's why I used to carry the GoPros around, the vlogs, because I would record my way driving to work and it would have caught that and made my life a whole lot easier. So what happened was, all right, so I'm going to need you to step out of the vehicle. I'm like, for what? I ain't even do shit. That's such bullshit. I'm cursing now. So now he's getting tight. He's upset. He's all these things. I get taken out the car and I get searched. But before the search happens, they ask people all the time, do you have any weapons on you? I'm like, I am the weapon. And I was like, nah, I got no weapons on me. Do you have anything on you that could poke or stab me? And I had to go, yes, I actually do. He's like, excuse me? I was like, yes, I have something that could stab you. I was like, you have a knife on you? No. I was like, maybe stab's the wrong word. I have something that could prick you. You have a needle on you. Yes. He looked at me, son, are you on the horse? It took me a minute to register what the fuck he was saying. I was like, what do you mean the horse? No, this is a Subaru. It's about maybe 172, 180 horsepower, but there's no real horse here. He was like, no, are you on heroin? I'm like, that's cute. That's very cute, very demure. That you would think that there are fat heroin addicts.
Very demure.
That's the most craziest shit I ever heard. Like, you know, you look like a heroin addict. I must be the most healthiest of heroin addicts out there in the world. Like, hey, man. Look pretty good for your size. You look real good. You lost a lot of weight. Are you on heroin? Is that what we're calling Ozempic now? That shit is crazy, son. That shit is crazy. But I was like, hold up. So I'm like, no, I'm a diabetic. I have to have needles on me. Not even the needles that would be the ones that you guys are used to, the heroin addicts. What I need is a little needle tip that screws into my pen and I can use it. Continue on with my day. But no. Get stopped. Get my time wasted. Get illegally searched. And they took my damn insulin away. But even when he looked at it, he was like, wait, this is the same needle for Ozempic. I'm like, sir, I'm the diabetic here. I'm pretty sure I'm the one that could tell you. It's a diabetic pen. So my bag is open. My bag that's in my passenger seat with all the fucking needles. And if you know anything about diabetic needles, they're all colorful. So you'll see like a little plastic bag and that shit looks like a bag of Skittles, but it's not, people. It's needles. All right. It's funny that the needles look like the shit that I would fucking eat. But yeah. Now, looks at the bag and sees all the fucking needles and he's like, the fuck you need so many needles for? And I'm like, got a lot of diabetes. He ain't appreciate that shit. So I was like, look, man, I'm just trying to get to the pharmacy and return these fucking needles. He's like, are they used? I was like, yo, we're doing way too much. We're doing way too much talking. I was like, the needles are going to expire by the time this fucking conversation's over. And he's just like, but you're going to jail. I'm like, wait, for what? wasn't speeding, didn't partake. So everything that happened, I ain't gonna tell you shit. FTP, what's up? I ain't say none of that shit. I was like, what do we need to do to resolve this conversation that we're having so I don't take my ass to jail? All right? That's all I need to know. You want some bussy? I have a guy cousin that I call my favorite cousin. I'll let you get that. But it was like the most funniest shit. I was like, yo. I was like, I can no longer answer that question. Like, hey, do you have a needle on you or anything that could prick me? I now have to be yes. Now I have to be a self-conscious civilian when I get pulled over and they start searching me. Like, that's the most craziest shit ever to me. I was like, hey, man, why don't you take me to dinner first before you fucking start molesting me? Shit. I wonder how many cases like that are there against NYPD where people that got patted down and they're like, hey, man, he fucking molested me. That's a great fucking question. Now, eventually, the guy pulls up and he's like, no, that's not him. Appreciate you, big boy. See, the Honda Civic was, for whatever reason, angry at him too. And they all decided to fuck with him. So I don't know how it ended, but I don't think it was bad since I didn't hear nothing about it. Now, as the ordeal is over, I'm over here like, damn, son. Damn. Got called a heroin addict today. That's fucking crazy. Like, hey, man, are you on heroin? And I'm like, why do you have some? Shit. That's fucking crazy, son. But, yeah, they eventually let me go. And I'm like, all right, and now I got to go to work. I wasn't going to work. Now I got to go to the pharmacy and see if I could do this exchange, which they didn't fucking take. And then I went to work. And then I got to explain that whole fucking ordeal that I went through. I'm like, shit. I was like, you really think I'm a heroin addict? You think we all just heroin addicts? Big, healthy-ass heroin addicts? It's fucking crazy. Heroin addicts. Name of the episode. Episode 131. Heroin addicts. Is this episode 131? It is episode 131. All right, so I'm going to move out of this section and go to the next section. And what I wanted to talk about was this movie that just came out tonight/yesterday for the grand premiere. Spoiler alert. Spoiler alert. Spoiler alert. If you don't want to hear what I'm about to say, please fast forward to the next section, which is the cool report. So what happened was, I didn't know this movie was supposed to come out. Didn't know. Did not know. I heard rumbles, but not that it was supposed to come out this week. And it came out kind of early. They said they had to release the movie 2 weeks early, so I kind of want to know what kind of shit they're, the filmmakers and directors are dealing with, since they had to push out a whole project that quickly. So it was pretty entertaining. So if you guys don't know what I'm talking about the movie The Terrifier. Now, this guy is a creature, or this thing is a creature that looks like a human but isn't a human, super strong, shit like that. It's fucking weird. So, in this one, I already heard that people walked out of the movies. A lot of movies will do promotion like that, and they'll be like, oh my God, they all watched this movie and they walked out. That's how scary it is. People were crying. And they show them with the night vision, people getting scared at the jump scenes. It's a whole thing. It's a whole production. It's pretty fucking cool. And then what made it crazy was in the first 5 minutes of the movie, people walked out because there are certain people in scary movies, horror movies that are no-goes. Like, no. You can't touch that subject line. You can't even think about that. We're going to ban you. That's what made Sinister such a great movie, because it was involving kids being the serial killer. So this movie, all right, there's evil kids. And they're still able to, like, maneuver through the astral plane field to find people to take over their shit. So this movie was like, in the beginning, it's Christmas. Christmas time. Kids are waiting for Santa. They get him. And the girl that makes some like cookies and milk, she wakes up, of course, and she notices him. And then she notices him go to the rooms of each of one of the people that are in the house, which is her parents and her older brother, which is like a 9-year-old. And he brutally murders the fuck out of that family. Brutally murders the fuck out of those kids. And that's always been like an iffy, like, no, you can't kill the wife and kids. He's killing wife and kids. He does not care. So, yeah, that's what it led to. It was like, all right, watching this movie, oh, shit, they really took it there. I even saw people at my movie theater get up and just walk out of there. And I'm like, I get it. No, I get it. I can see why. But what made this movie interesting is that this movie, when did the first one come out? What year? I could tell you the one that I read was that it had a $35,000 budget, which is not bad, because I think the minimum that you need is $25,000, so you get an extra $10,000. So, what's the name of this movie? The Terrifier. So the first film came out in 2016, and then it get buzzed until like 2021 or 2. What year are we in? We're in 24. So this movie didn't get buzzed until the 2024, and it took off. So the first movie had 35K. I don't know. I can't tell you how much the second one had, but it was a pretty good movie. If you're looking for gore, that's the movie to watch. If you're there for acting, go watch porn. But it was like, that's how night and day that it was. And it was just so gruesome. It was so crazy that I was like, I think there's something wrong with me. I'm still watching this movie, eating my chips as he's killing and mutilating the hell out of a person on the screen. And I'm like, these chips are delicious. Also, I'm not down with the movie theaters that want to do like popping scares. Like they'll have like the nun and she'll chase you in there. Nah, I'm good, because I'm letting you know right now. Any clowns try to like chase me in a movie theater, it's curtains. All right. Curtains. All right. But this movie kept up to the goriness. It kept up to all that stuff, which is like, all right, it's cool. The one thing that I did notice is what they should have did was put more money into acting classes for the characters that they had listed, because they needed more character development and to actually look normal and natural in it. So what they did spend their money on was people that were already on the scene that people already knew of, and they were like amazing at what they do. So there's was one guy, his name was Tom Savini, I believe. Savini is the last name, I can't remember the first name. And he was in it. I was like, it must have cost a pretty penny to get him, because they probably hired him for props, because he's really amazing what he does. Because at the end of the day, the old shit from back in the day is way better than the CGI that we're using today. So he was that. So it was a mess. It was a mess. Like, if you're watching that for the first time, you're probably going to walk out. If you had no idea what it was, you were going to walk out. So, yeah, it's crazy shit. But the only issue that I had was like, all right, you spent all your money on the B-list celebrities, and you should have got more people, more acting skills, because it was still like, oh, God. It was like a 2B film with like a good budget. So it was really interesting. And even at one point, Michael Myers came to the fight and he's like, hey, man, what's going on? Everyone's like, hey, if you don't get your big ass back home, ain't nobody even talking to you. So, yeah. Terrifier was a crazy, 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 crazy movie that I'm probably going to not ruin for you guys until you guys go watch it. We'll wait, go watch the other Terrifiers, because they're just as good. All right. From the 35 one to the second one to this one. They have money behind it, and it's all been good. So, not much to complain about. Hey, yo, 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 welcome back, welcome back, welcome back. If you're watching the video, you're going to notice something different, all right? You never guess what happened. If you were watching the video, you could tell in the first 40 minutes I was falling asleep because I was recording at 2 o'clock in the morning. And then, fast forward to the video, it is clearly the morning now. Now, I don't like the way this camera looks. Can I move this over a little bit more? I'll fix it later. Yeah. It's morning time. So what was I speaking about? The Terrifier. Terrifier is a good movie, all right? It's a good movie if you go to watch it with the idea of no storyline. It's just pure what I want it to be, gore. The whole purpose of the series is like, yo, this is fucked up. What is the worst thing that somebody could possibly do to somebody else? And then they do it, all right? There was a scene so bad in the movie, I don't know if I mentioned it yet because I fell asleep, where the person that plays Art the Clown throws up in the behind the scenes. Because even he, who does all the crazy shit, was like, wow, that's a lot. Like this plane that's going to hover over my damn house. He's like, how does a plane hover over your damn house? You're hearing it right now. It's fucking lingering. But yeah, that was the most craziest thing. I'm like, wait. I'm like, I was trying to figure out what scene it was. And I did mention it. I was like, yo, that's the scene. I'm like, that's the scene right there. I could see why the people left in the beginning of the movie, but to the scene that where he was like, all right, that's a lot. That, like, we're doing too much. That was the part where I saw, I was like, fuck it, I'm gonna spoil it for y'all. All right, man. So this dude just killed her uncle-in-law, right? Killed her uncle-in-law. So it's Christmas. This is taking place around Christmas. So he makes the dude into like a tree, like nails him to the wall, cuts off his head, draws a little fake head. He has his intestines open all the way, and there's a fight sequence. So the fight sequence is taking place next to the body. Dude grabs her head, right, and shoves it inside of his body, like right between like where the belly button and the penis is. Right in there, smushes it in there, and then you would think that's enough, right? You would think that's enough. Like, oh shit, that's fucked up. Then she falls down like the way they always do in the movies, and he takes the intestines and wraps it around her neck. So now she's fighting to get the intestines off her neck. And then she gets it around her mouth and she starts chewing through it to get off. And she finally chews through it. All this shit is bad enough. Like, literally, like, shit. I don't know what part of the intestines it was yet. But bites into it. And then you see all this shit just go, oh, man. I was like, I get it. Who thought of that? What sick person thought of that scene? Because that was some wild shit. That was literally wild shit. But yeah, man, the Terrifier 3. It's going to be... It's an issue, man. If you liked the first one, second one, because the second one was crazy. So there was a scene in the second one, right? I don't know if I mentioned it, whatever. You're going to hear it twice. Where he's killing this girl, right? So he pulls up to the crib, hits her. She wakes up. My son hatchets one of her arms. See, he doesn't hatchet clean off. He wants you to have like something dangling. So when you get up, you'll see that shit and you freak out more. So she fell to the ground, and then my son started scalping her. I was like, wow, that's a lot. No, to them it wasn't. Because then he cuts like a good, he does like a nice square shape cut on her back and peels the skin, but he starts skinning her basically. So he leaves the flap down, he disappears. Everybody's like, oh shit, bitch, get up and run away. And clearly she ain't listened to us. Because then he comes in with salt and starts rubbing it in her wounds, and bleach just starts rubbing it in her wounds and takes the fucking flap and puts it back on her. Like, that's some wild, crazy shit to think of. And be like, you know what would be crazy? If we do this, what else can we do? That's not a lot. That's not a lot already. No, we can do more. So it was like, fuck that shit. But Terrifier 3, gory. Gory as hell. Gory as hell. All right. Hopefully I was able to save that section, even though I know I was falling asleep. My bad, people. My bad. All right, so let's go to the fun part.
We interrupt this program for an important news announcement.
Welcome to the Cool Report. Boy, do I got some ignorance. Boing, 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 boing. All right, J. Cole responds to the beef. Can I honestly say I love Cole. Love J. Cole. Love J. Cole music. Huge fan. I know a bunch of his lyrics by heart. When Cole was going, before the beef, Cole was going on this roll, right? I've said this before. Cole was going everywhere and he was like, yo, I'm the best out there. I'm a killer. You're not going to like going against me. You don't even want me on your verse. And everybody was like, all right, I'm going to shut the fuck up. Cole was even disrespectful and went on people's verses. And he was like, yeah, I'm better than the person I'm rhyming with right now. What's he going to say? Those were the sentiments of his bars. And foolish them, they left those bars in, which made me go, oh, he's a fucking killer. Because if I'm a rapper, if I'm an artist, and you're giving me bars my way, nah, son, pull that shit up. We catching a fade. Don't call it lyrical sparring, because it's not lyrical sparring. You're taking shots at me. You're trying to hurt me. Fuck that. So here comes the beef. He was like, nah, man, I don't want to be part of it. It wasn't right in my soul. No, I can't rap. No. If you really felt like that, then you would have never made the bars to begin with. That's just me. That's how I think. I hope you guys didn't see. Oh, Jesus Christ. But I find myself talking to a lot of Cole fans, and they're like, no, see, he did respond, but he didn't want to do this because of that. I'm like, fam, no, it's bullshit. It's bullshit, because you've been saying all this time that you want smoke, and here comes the smoke. You want to be tested lyrically? Here it came. So everybody's like, well, it didn't stay lyrical. It went to a mudflinging contest. You're right. You're absolutely right. But what I've heard from the industry was there was a meeting before anything happened. There was a meeting between the OVO camp and the TDE camp. And they were like, all right, we could go two ways. All right. We could keep it lyrical miracle. I'll kill you there. But if you get dirty, if you mention anything, if you even think of talking about my family, I'm going to violate. And guess what Drake did? He talked about the family. So son got violated. See, Drake has been down this ramp where when you mention somebody's family, we will go even harder. We're putting you through the fucking earth. This has happened twice. He didn't learn. He should have learned from the first one, because he didn't handle the first one good either. And he lost that battle. People are like, no, he didn't. He lost that battle. Because after that, nah, I don't want to rap no more. And then continued to throw subliminals. This is what he's doing right now. He lost his battle. He lost. Anybody that says anything different, you're smoking dust. Lost the battle. Now, he's like, oh, but I'm ready for round two. No, there is no round twos. No. This isn't Nas versus Jay-Z. Remember when Jay-Z lost that battle? He tried to re-bring it up. He did the Blueprint H-O-V-A. The Blueprint 2, baby. I love that song. But no, it's not enough to restart the battle. You lost the battle. I think he could have won it if he never apologized. Because what you need to understand is, like, yo, at the end of the day, your mother is not responsible for the outcome of the rap. My mom, I let you know right now, my mom does not agree with the majority of the things I say on this. But I'm going to continue saying what I'm saying because this is my platform. Now, the day I step over the lines and say some wild, borderline, outlandish shit, and my mom's like, yo, really? Like, yo, you need to really, like, relax. I would hear her out. And then from there, I would determine, like, okay, that's enough. But in a rap beef, if I was in a podcast beef, ooh, we're kind of getting there. If I was in a podcast beef, I will turn this background into a fucking green screen. And I will really violate, because I'm nice like that. But, yeah, in wartime, or lyrical wartime, the person that surrenders, nobody gives a shit about him more. So we all said it. Well, I felt like it. So I'll say it again. I don't want to hear. I'll come in the booth and catch a body like the coroner. I don't want to hear that. I want to hear that. So just rap about however rap different. Whistle, hum. I want to hear it. Like, you go rap about riding your bike. You go rap about all these other things. You'll kill it, but I don't want to hear like, yo, you know, bars are so fire. My enemies catch on fire and they need to retire. And like, yo, fam. I don't want to hear it. Like, that's all it is, right? So I saved a portion because it was the what he was saying that people were like trying to dick ride that shit. Oh, don't tell me they deleted it. They deleted it? All right, let's see if I can find it. Because he basically got on stage and he was like, well, this didn't happen because of this. And I didn't want this to happen. And why would I want this to happen? All right, that's Rory and Maul talking. I don't know. That's that shit with a. That's not good. That's gonna ruffle feathers. Really? This is the Dodgers are faced the Mets in the NLC. There's a fire on my block. What the hell? Where? Where on my block? There's a fire. All right. My bad, people. This should have been. I had it saved. I really did have it saved. I don't know where the hell it went. Oh my God, everybody's like sucking his dick. Maul goes off. I know that one. All right, I guess I have to play it. Oh, I'm not even connected. Hold up. Give me 1 second. It's a new song, so I don't think they're going to flag it. I don't think they're going to flag it. So let's see how this goes. All right, Bluetooth. Activate. Yo, microphone, I need you to stop fucking around. All right. So. All right, so let's see. Let's get it.
I hate when raps become, but like, do not disturb signs. Cannot get it if I see it's about the dough. They instigate the fuckery because it's profitable.
He's blaming us.
Stop the violence tools with dudes in hospitals.
He's saying it's our fault.
I seen where that was about to go. They wanted blood. They wanted clicks to make their pockets grow. They see this fire in my pen and think I'm dodging smoke. I wouldn't have lost the battle, dog. I would have lost the pro.
Yay.
I would have gained a foe. And all for what? Just to attain some old props from strangers that don't got a clue what I've been aiming for since the age of. I hate when raps become, but like, do not disturb signs. Cannot get it if I see it's by 14. Jermaine is no king, if that means I gotta dig up dirt and pay the whole team of algorithm bot niggas just to sway the whole thing on social media. Competing for your favorable memes to be considered best, a living rest, the weight of both things. I understand the thirst of being first that made them both swing, protecting legacies. So lines got crossed, perhaps regrettably. My friends went to war, I walked away with all they blood on me. Now some will discredit me, try wipe away my pedigree, but please find a nigga out that's rapping this incredibly. My dog texted me, I shed a. They stripped me of my spot and now I'm finally free, my nigga. They say I'm picking sides, hey, don't you lie on me, my nigga. To start another war, hey, Drake, you'll always be my nigga. I ain't ashamed to say you did a lot for me, my nigga. Fuck all the narratives. Tapping back into your magic pen is what's imperative. Reminding these folks why we do it. It's not for beefing, it's for speaking our thoughts. Pushing ourselves, reaching the charts. Reaching your minds, deep in your hearts. Creeping up something inside to.
If you don't get this bullshit out of here, son, this is bullshit. You know, for somebody that didn't want to rap, somebody that didn't want to partake, you're doing a lot of fucking rapping here, son. Because he's throwing it on us. He's like, yo, you know, the reason the fans wanted this and they try to put us all together and we're supposed to be bros and blah, blah, blah. Kendrick does not like fucking Drake. Kendrick does not like him. Whatever happened, whatever he saw, my son didn't just, it wasn't a light jab. He fucking basically grabbed him by that OVO chain and punched him the fuck out that shit. You don't do that to somebody that you like. You don't. They don't like each other, son. They don't. If you want to say it's a money ploy, all right, cool, granted. All right, I could get that. But all these things that came out, nah. And the fact that people were like, oh my God, Kendrick is going through this nasty, like, thing with his wife, like they're separated and he allegedly hit her and all this shit. It's all in Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers. He literally starts the album with, but by the time this come out, she's already out of my life. So what the fuck, what are we talking about? But that's another thing. But I was like, yo, like somebody that didn't want to partake in the battle, somebody that didn't want to be like, hey man, this is what's going on. Da, 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 da. Nah, son, I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it, son. You should have partook in the battle. You could have went lyrical miracle and not thrown shit at nobody. Because I genuinely don't think there's nothing to throw at J. Cole. J. Cole doesn't seem like he hangs out with people. He doesn't seem like an industry person. The same way Rick Ross went at Drake and they kept it separate, that you could have did that too. But that's the issue. See, I think Drake would have probably caught a higher... Drake would have been looked at better if J. Cole stepped into the beef. Because it was... The way it looked like it was Drake against Drake, it was Kendrick, Rick Ross, Future, YG, and there was more people to list that jumped in. And I would have been like, all right, look at all these people that it takes to take out Drake. He's a goon. And the other thing that I want to mention is, like, I'm not dumb. Like, I know what Drake is. Drake is an issue. Drake is a problem. He drops a heater. I know I mentioned before that he's a little warm right now, and it's still true to this day because he has nothing that's come out. But when I was with my cousin last week, and he was like playing a song, he's like, yeah, this shit's fire. I was like, I know it's fire, bro. Like, this is Drake at the end of the day. I'm never going to match, like, complain about, like, what his pen is. But it was, like, the route that he took, I think he could have went better. I think it could have went better if he wasn't going against an artist that was prepared for him. That's what I think. Because that last one, not the one that he tapped out to, Family Matters, that shit was fucking fire. And everybody that does podcasting music, I think we all said the same shit. Like, yo, if he just focused on Kendrick, because why am I focusing on Rick Ross? He's calling me white. Oh, shit. Okay. He has more money. Bullshit. Like, I'm not even talking to that. But if Cole was, like, saying something like, I'm a better artist, all right, I'll respond to that. But I would have dropped Family Matters strictly for Kendrick. Because that line that makes me laugh all the time, he's like, there is another big dream. There is only Big D, and there's video proof. That shit makes me fucking laugh every time. So it's like, all right, that's him being witty. That's him playing to his shit, and that's what I like. Why they got in the mud for, that's another thing I would never know. But Cole, I don't want to hear none of that goddamn shit you saying, all right? Blaming us because you were told to put your steel to the test. Put your sword to the test. Ayo, pause. Nah, son. Nah. This is for you, Cole. And it hurts me. But you're the cuck of the week. Do roosters even make those noises, or is that just a chicken? I don't know. There goes my chances of ever being cool with J. Cole if he ever sees this shit. Damn. In the classic words of Drake, you're dead. Let me stop. He's not dead. We just don't want to hear it. Well, I can't speak for you. I don't want to hear it. Like, get in the booth and catch the bodies. Wide receivers, big believers. Nigga, shut up. I want to hear that shit. Don't want to hear it. You were given your chance to be battle tested. Your fight literally was right in front of you. Your fight was literally right here. Somebody stepped to you. He was like, all right. And that's what people don't get. Because I was talking to Cole defenders. And they was like, nah, man, you don't get it. And I'm like, no, you don't get it. That's like me popping off every day. Like, I will fuck you up. I will kick your ass. I will do this to you. They won't be able to identify the body. Just popping off like that. But when you go finally go, all right, you know what? I think it's time to do it. And you're like, nah, you're lucky. Not today, man. I'm a little bit busy. You would look at that person crazy, son. You would look at them like, nah, man, I'll kill you. I'll do this so bad, man. Like, nobody's buying it now, sir. Nobody's buying it. Just go down a different avenue like Drake's going down. You're solidified. Don't get it twisted. You're still J. Cole. Like, I think he would have to catch a body if he wants to come back. Or partake. Like, now he has to get on the offensive and just become offensive and diss somebody of their magnitude. Go at Drake now. Go at Cole. Because they're not your friends now. Maybe Kendrick, but I don't think Drake is your friend now. Because you left him out to hang and get jumped. I can't be friends with somebody that left me out to hang and get jumped. You watched as I got fucking verbally accosted? No, I'm sorry. Kendrick just opened his mouth. Someone just went in the house. Shit. You're dead. I actually wanted to make that like a thing on the show. Where I'm like, you're dead. But I didn't find a good thing. All right. Mount Everest climber discovered. Guess where? On Mount Everest. I wonder why. So that's the one place they tell you, like, hey, man, you fuck around, you're going to find out. And when you find out, they won't never find out that you find out until somebody stumbles across you accidentally. So what happened was this climber that goes up there. What did they even say his name? I don't think they said. Okay, some guy named Jimmy Chin. That's a fire name. This guy was climbing Everest, and upon his travels, he stumbled across the body. It's not very uncommon to stumble across a body of a place that's filled with bodies. That's like me going to the cemetery and be like, oh shit, do you know there's bodies here? So he was en route to the top of the summit. That's what they like to call the top of the mountain, the summit. And he discovered a leg. So out of curiosity, he goes to check it. Okay. The leg belongs to a guy that's been missing for 100 years. His name is Andrew Cummin Sandy Irvin. So 100 years, 2024, 1924 is when he went. I don't think they had North Face back in the day, or Canada Gooses or anything, or any of the cool shit that we have now. So in the picture, I see his leg and what looks like to be wool pants, but you can never tell, and a scarf, but you can never tell what the real, well, it's, I think everything would be frozen and all your shit would be kept intact. I don't know. But it looks like he has boots and a wool scarf. So I'm wondering, 1924, I don't really think global warming was happening yet. So you were at the peak of the coldest of times to go, and boots and a scarf. So wonder what happened. Not to speak ill of the dead, but that's the way it's coming off. Now, apparently he was being watched by a telescope as he was going up the summit and getting close to his thing. So the conversation was, nobody ever knew if he ever made it. If he ever made it. And he died going, if he died going up or if he died coming back. The picture doesn't answer it because I think it might because of the way the angle is, but it's a mountain. So I don't fucking know. It doesn't answer it because it's like, all right, there's no clear sign. It's like this way to the mountain, but like this way to the top. Now, the bigger question that nobody's asking, not one person's asking is, all right, this guy, he's been missing for 100 years. The summit is defrosting because now all these bodies are being discovered. This body was missing for 100 years. 100 years worth of snow is now visible. At first, everybody thought this guy was in a cave. Like, oh, he must be in a cave somewhere. Like, frozen to death in a cave. All right? No luck. Buried underneath snow. Because while he was going up, getting close to the top, a snowstorm appeared. And then he didn't appear. He just disappeared. So, it was some crazy shit because, you know, what's crazy? How much does it cost to climb that? Because that's only rich people shit. That's only rich people shit. Rich people like doing things. Like, they like paying to go die. Like, they like paying. It's, at what point does it not become an adventure and it's just you just fucking around with your life? Because you got to think about the submarine, the people that were in the submarine that died like that. And they paid how much money for those tickets? And then I just told you maybe a week or two ago that people are flying into space and the FAA is like, yo, that shit is not safe. Like, there's rules and regulations he's not following. It's going to be a shit show one day. And everyone's like, eh, nah. And now you got people that go to Mount Everest and climb it. And they're told, like, yo, if you die up there, we are not coming to retrieve your body. How much to climb Everest? They call it K2. Oh. All right. The price range can go from $35,000 to $160,000. Side of the mountain guided trip to the south side of the mountain with bottle of oxygen and typically go around $45,000 while on the trip. $35,000 on the north side. $45,000 for oxygen. That's fucking crazy. You know what? Permit fee. Climbers must pay a permit fee to the Nepal government of $11,000 per person. You know what? I've been having thoughts lately. It might be a little off. But God, do you know they're making us pay for shit that you gave us for free? Do you know that? They're making us pay to go places that you created for free, Lord. Get them. Smite them. You know what? Bring the great flood that's happening. Bring it. Stop attacking Florida and like go over there real quick. Like let all that water just come down and clean them off. $11,000 to climb is fucking crazy. For something that was already there before these assholes. And it's not like they're maintaining the mountain. They're not. Because they're actually dirtying the mountain. They're polluting the mountain. They're leaving dead bodies all over the fucking mountain. So what are we doing? What are we talking about? I feel this conversation goes to little people like you and I. I know you're going to be like, we're not the same. Yes, we are. Because we pay to go to the beach. Something that was already fucking there. We paid it. We pay to be on land that was already there. All right. You could charge me for the bringing the water and the electricity, but charge me property tax to stay on my fucking land is crazy. What's crazy as shit? Charging me for water is crazy. Now, you're like, well, the water goes through like a vein. I get that part, but charging me for bottled water is crazy. Why can't I just go to that river my goddamn self? Maybe if you didn't fuck up the environment so much, we would be able to use rainwater and clear it out and fix it. I just found out there's places that make my brain's on a tangent. I just found out there's places that's using our literal shit, literally our poop. People are eating poop. The Haitians are eating dogs and the people are eating and the rest of the world is eating shit if you buy artificial meat. That's what they're using. That's the main ingredient. Ding, 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 ding. That's the main ingredient. Shit. They're taking shit, recycling it, and making it into artificial meat. You could Google that yourself. I know I remember Google. I am not the place you should get your news from. Nah, you could Google that shit yourself. That shit was fucking crazy when I saw that. Because not New York City. New York City has the finest water. Fuck you guys. But there's California. I think I mentioned it before. California, there's a reverse osmosis on the sewage water. The water that you shit in and flush into the sewers. Yeah, they're taking that water and cleaning it back up and sending it back to your pipes. So, yeah. Somebody's going to be like, well, they're doing that in New York. I don't drink water. Have you ever seen me drink a bottle of water on the show? Let you know right now. My piss is thick and yellow, which is probably unhealthy. But, yeah. Stop fucking with the water. But, shit is crazy, son. But yeah, this guy gets discovered 100 years later. They can't do nothing. They're going to leave his body there. And does he even have relatives that are still alive? They'll be like, all right, we'll take... No, that's a burden. Nah, fuck that. I just thought about that now. No. I'm letting you know right now, if any of my relatives magically come out of the woodworks that, oh, man, do you know you had a... that climbed... I gotta bleep that. Do you know that you had all my Cool J relative that climbed the mountain? Do you? Well, we just found him. All right, so now you got to pay to get his body the fuck off the mountain. All right, so it's going to cost $35,000 to get the helicopter to go get the body, another $20,000 in transportation, another $15 to $20 to bury them. That is a burden. Leave him there. No, I'm not claiming them. I'm sorry. That's crazy, son. Now that I think about it, if that person didn't come from wealth and is like, all right, well, now here comes this bill. Nope. 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 Hell no. That's crazy, son. What's next on the Cool Report? Elon Musk unveils new things. So, if you guys haven't been paying attention, Mr. Musk, they're going to sue the shit out of you, sir. Well, they've been suing the shit out of you, sir. But they're going to sue. If I'm the person and director of the movie iRobot, I am suing the fuck out of you. Because my son just took all the concepts from iRobot and brought them to life. All the concepts. He created the Android. Would it be an Android? Yeah, the Android looking thing with the face. Word for word, bar for bar. Yo, that shit was crazy, son. To see that, and I'm like, sir, we've seen this already.
Over the top.
He unveiled it like that was like the new fire. I'm like, oh hell no. So this new Android. All right, so they made these robots, right? So they're supposed to give you a hand. They go on for $20,000. They're supposed to give you a hand with everyday life. You need somebody to take the kids to school, watch the kids. You want somebody to make you breakfast. You want somebody to just hand. You want somebody just to be your personal slave 24/7. There you go right there. This is what this thing's for. He also mentioned, like a little side tangent, but I think we're all there. I mentioned it before. Hey, people are not liking people anymore. The robots are, haven't I been saying that? The robots are coming, and now the robots are going to be coming. Son, they said it's a you could use it as a companion. They're going to start fucking these robots, y'all. They're going to add like pussy attachments and dick attachments to these shits. It's going to be a fucking problem. It's going to be a problem, son. The robots are coming, son. Now, everything seems cool, but we all know people are disgusting. Somebody's going to fuck a robot, all right? I'm just mad it's not going to be me to be the first one to fuck a robot. Cause like, I don't have $20,000 in expendable money to go buy a robot just to fuck, all right? Even though the balance kind of makes sense because you're going to eventually spend $20,000 on a girl just to fuck. But I know. But yeah, now that was cool. I was like, all right, robot. And I'm like, how strong are they? Because the ones that iRobot were strong as fuck. They were flinging motherfuckers. I'm like, all right, I need like a little thing that stops them from attacking me. Then he dropped the robo taxi. That shit looks ugly. And the biggest thing that iRobot's gonna come for is the minivan. This minivan looks like every minivan. This minivan looks like every vehicle that ever made in a future movie. It looks exactly like, it looks like a fucking toaster. It looks like a toaster. I don't know about you, but I'm not be trying to committing suicide on that shit is crazy, son. Cause it'll be equivalent. All right, so if I wanted to kill myself in that if I wanted to unalive myself, I gotta block a lot of these things. If I wanted to unalive myself in one of those toasters, I would drive it into the ocean for the irony because I could have did that at home. But no, I just took my toaster into Jones Beach and drove that shit right into the water. What is it going to do? Electrocute me and possibly fill up with water. I mean, you heard this here first, people. If any of this shit starts happening. Oh, no. Wait. That could go against me, too. Never mind. Refer to the front of the tag. Yeah, I like that better. But yeah, my son made a toaster on wheels. And he was like, ta-da. Now, what I will give this man is he's pretty out there with his experiments. He's pretty there. Now, recently, where I work in the health industry, they just developed their own Neuralink. And it's so light years behind his technology because he created a Neuralink. That it fails in comparison to deliver what it's supposed to look like. So what I mean by that is that, all right, the neural link that he created goes in the side of his head. Boom, done. 3 bolts into your skull and you're done. All right. The neural link that they created at this workplace was drilled right into the center of your head, wire running out of it, and it's connected to the computer that connects to 10 more different things, and it's crazy. So apparently this guy that they were working on, he was paralyzed. What was it again? Skiing accident. I mean, do what you love, but once I hear that, I'm like, oh, okay, you kind of put yourself there. But yeah, skiing, paralyzed from chest down. No, from neck down. Couldn't move. Installed the machine. He could feel now. It's sending signals to his brain. Like, all right, I know what this feels like. I can move my arm. Cool. Still confined to a chair. All right. Not cool. But we're getting there. Technology is moving around. Now, in China, they have exoskeleton suits, people. What do they use the exoskeleton suits for? To work in warehouses so they don't wear out their workers. All right. So it helps them pick up to like 150 to 180 pounds if you have to. It makes them walk around. It helps them. It's just basically an aid. And I'm like, do you guys not talk to each other? Do you guys not read the stories the way I read the stories? Why won't you put the chip and connect it to an exoskeleton suit? And then this person's able to walk around again without the need of a chair. He would probably have to go and put like a hoist by the bed or in the bathroom so they could use the facilities, or he could just walk around Huggies all day. I don't think that's going to be fun at all. But the hoist, boom, go to sleep. You're kind of back to normal again. Kind of back to normal again, right? Is that too much? Am I over here overthinking it? Is something not lining up with my ideas?
It's not right.
Are we all lefts? So, yeah, it was like crazy. I'm like watching this. I was like, well, we already have this. And if you guys would collab, it'll probably go better. But nobody wants to collab with this guy for whatever reason. So I was like, okay. Well, I guess it would be deemed too much power or some shit, because he does have a lot of power. He has his fingers on a lot of shit. So kind of like me when I be with the girl and stuff. Yeah, it's crazy, son. Just to think that, hey, man, you could probably go work with this person and make something happen over there. Get shit shaken over there. And like, nah, we're fine over here. The fuck you are. But, yeah, Mr. Elon Musk is getting us closer every day to have these robots take over. Every day. So, yeah, weird. All right, I think I'm going to get out of this section. Don't know how I did with that section. Hopefully it's better. I didn't get all political on you guys, because that's all that they've been talking about lately is politics, and it's hard not to talk about it. And you know, I give the best takes, the beautifulest takes. Some people will walk into a room and be like, wow, that's a take. But let me go into the Ask Me a Question section.
Wait, Jose, I got to tell you something.
I'm mad I didn't get to use that last time. I totally forgot I had that drop. But we're in the Ask Me a Question section. Everybody's favorite section. Psych. All right, let's get into it. All right. Are you buying these new rules when couples get into an argument and one won't let the other leave? It is now considered kidnapping. I know what you want me to say. I know you want to be like,
it's not right.
But
listen here, you fucking goon. It is not okay. Not okay to hold somebody against their will when they're trying to leave. I know some of us grew up seeing that, but that doesn't make it right. Does it? So I feel like I should be having this conversation in my normal voice, but no, I kind of like hearing this, like, because it's like, rah, rah, rah. I sound like a monster like you guys are.
Let me stop. Yeah, I'm with it. You know what it's supposed to do in society? We're supposed to evolve in a society. We're supposed to be like, all right, that's not right. We shouldn't be doing that. All right. Like, people don't like the way I take things on, because I know the way I am. I know the way I am. I know how bad I can get. So people don't like that when I have an issue with them, and it goes beyond like, I step away. I don't partake. I don't engage in the conversation to fix shit no more. I don't engage to clear the view anymore. like, all right, like, oh, why'd you do that? I'm not even explaining it no more. I'm going to move on. Everybody's like, that's passive aggressive. That's this, that's that. It's true, but it also leads away from a gigantic fallout. See, I leave the door open so maybe one day I could come back. But if I were to go into like full, like what I would really say, there's no coming back. There's no coming back. All right. So it's like, cool. But a lot of the times people get into arguments, people fight, and they try to be like, where the fuck you going? Sometimes you hear that. Sometimes. That's a no. That's a no. All right. That's a mm-mm. Also in New York City, I don't know about anywhere else. I found out that, all right, so the conversation back in the day was like, all right, there would be a domestic dispute, right? Police would come. They'll be like, hey, do you want to drop the charges? All right, I'm skipping. A domestic dispute is happening. Let's say you're arguing with your girl, right? She gets crazy. You throw something. She calls the cops. She doesn't feel safe. She shouldn't have to feel like that, but that's another thing. Heat of the moment, we're going to chalk it up to that. Emotions, all right? Calls the cops. Cops show up. All right. You're going crazy. You're fucking around. Are you going to leave? No. Okay. Do you want him to go to jail? Yes. Heat of the moment. Okay. Hour, 2 hours later. All right. I want to drop charges. I want him out of jail. And they would normally let you go. You would be like, you go in front of the judge or the police officer would be like, all right, man, they're not doing shit. Let them go. The hold's over. All right. That is no longer the case. In New York City, I don't know if it's like in Long Island, but I know in New York City, because, you know, they have different sets of rules. You could go through that same scenario. Your girl could be like, all right, I want to drop the charges. It's like, no. I mean, that's fine. You could drop your charges. But we're still going to continue with charging his ass. So that was like a crazy thing that people used to be like, get into arguments, call the police. Somebody go, all right, I want him out. Get him out of there. And they'll let him out. That's not the case up here. Over here, you go away, the state starts looking for charges to bring up on your ass. So it's crazy, Sunday. It was like, all right, since you're not going to do it, we're going to take it upon ourselves to punish him for you. So, yeah, or her, two-way street. Studies show that girls are more violent, FYI, in case you didn't know. The violence rate in women and men are high. Women and women higher. So that's top. Man, woman, second place. Men, low third, super low. I mean, you can check those up yourself. So, ladies, it's y'all. Who said that? Did you guys hear that shit? So, yeah. You just can't tell somebody they can't leave. You're forcibly holding them against their will. That is called kidnapping. That is. Holding me against my will is kidnapping, all right? I know somebody's going to be like, oh, my God, he's so sassy. Oh, my God. This is what we got to deal with, guys. That's what we got to deal with. So sassy. Oh, my God. This is what we got to deal with. These are the men that are out there nowadays. I'm like, nah, some of y'all just hate that some of us have boundaries. Some of y'all hate. The most funniest shit I heard is, I forgot what we were talking about. It took place at work. This took place at work. And all right, I'm in charge of the music in my job. There were days I don't want to be in charge of music. There's days I just want to listen to some podcast. So like this girl comes up to me. She's like, yo, come on, man. I want to listen to music. Can you play some music? I'm like, nah, I'm not in the mood. I'm not really in a good mood. Oh my God. You're so sassy. Oh my, he's sensitive. He's all in his feelings. He's such a cancer. And I'm like, because I said I'm not in the mood. I don't want to listen to the music. What's stopping you from playing the music? But I'm like, as I sit back and look at the grander scale of things, I oppose to ask the same question to the ladies in my office. And they all said the same shit. That's sassy. You don't want to play the music because you're in your feels? And I'm like, I'm obligated? That's something that has to automatically happen. Is that what I'm providing here? Is this where I become the big, strong, broly man by providing the reggae music? The 50s music? The lit music and stuff. But stripper music. I'm like, is that what it is? I was like, y'all using me? I'm not a piece of meat. But yeah. But I'm letting you know right now, ladies, if we're together and I want to get the fuck away from you, I'm like, yo, let me just walk away. Let me just take a breather. Let me go gather my thoughts. Let me go do this shit. I hate it when you gather your thoughts. And you stop me. You detain me for whatever reason. You hold me. You grab me. You accost me. I am pressing charges. All right. Now I'm sassy. I'm going to be in jail. I'm going to be in the courtroom like, she did it, Your Honor. I need $1 million for emotional distress because I can't sleep anymore. And now I no longer have a body next to me to lay next to anymore. My body pillow doesn't cut it anymore. That's a body pillow. I don't know if you guys can see that. Freaky ass body pillow. But yeah, these are the laws, people. These are laws. You're going to be like, well, they're man-made laws. Yeah, yeah, they need to be, because you shouldn't be holding somebody against their will. You shouldn't be holding somebody against their will and then continue to put them down, if that's the way the argument's going. All right? You should let that person just want to walk away. What's the problem? They come back. They're going to come back. Especially if they live there, they're going to come back. Talk when there's cooler heads is basically what I'm saying. Because in the heat of the moment, you're going to say something. She's going to say something. It's going to get a whole lot worse. All right, move on to the next question. Why did you do hip hop like that last week? I ain't do shit. They did it to themselves, all right? They did it to themselves. Why would you give such a list like that? A list like that and not think that it was going to get responded to that way? That's a better question. So if you're mad at that list, I got another list for you guys. It's when rappers were lying and said that their protege was going to be the next and up and coming rapper. First on the list is Soulja Boy with A-Rap. I ain't never heard A-Rap spit a bar in my life. So how is he going to be up and coming? That's number one on the list. How many of them are here? I don't even know. Jay-Z is my favorite artist. Jay-Z is one of my favorite artists. One, I think, kills it every time he goes. He has a couple of songs that are, but yeah. Him backing Memphis Bleek, I never get why. I would never get it. Memphis Bleek is one of the most trashiest rappers out of New York City. There goes my card, but somebody had to say it. I don't know why they thought that was, why he thought that was the guy. What's crazy is that he overlooked Kanye. He didn't even want Kanye to be the person to to rap. He said, Kanye, you make beats. That's what you're good at. Kanye's another one that's up there. Lil Wayne, oh God. Gutta Gutta. Lil Wayne really was pushing Gutta Gutta. See, he got lucky with two. But before he got to those two, he had a lot of questionable people like Gutta Gutta. Do I know a Gutta Gutta line? I don't think I do. He said, yo, they're violent. He looked like Young M.A. He's bagging up groceries now. His whole Bedrock verse made no sense. Yo, see, people are mean. Next person is Who the Kid. That's Gucci Mane's guy. Never heard of him. Belongs on the list. J.R. Writer, Cameron. Yeah, I would put him on this. A lot of people are like, well, he wrote a lot of music for Cam and he writes a lot of music. That's why they call him the writer. Yeah, but when it came to your projects, it was pretty bad. You never took off because you didn't know how to make a song for your goddamn self. Some people can write shit and some people don't know how to structure it properly. Like, I could write some shit. That's my issue too. I don't know how to structure it properly. My cousin makes me laugh because he goes, every time I hear you do these like terrible attempts at freestyles, he's like, I see you like playing hopscotch, trying to get in. And when you think you're in, you're not really in. That's what she says too, Buzz. So, yeah. J.R. Writer, sorry. Lil Wayne again. Corey Guns. I don't think he was ever backing up Corey Guns like that. Corey Guns was nice, but he's another one. He ain't do shit. He ain't do shit with his career. What are they saying about Corey Guns? Lima Bean, when he did his thing, a Lima Bean. I'm a Lima Bean. Yeah, he was nice, but he ain't do nothing. Yeah, he kept getting locked up. See, that's the thing. There's people that could do things, and they put themselves in positions to not to be able to do things. And that's the problem right there. Because why are you putting yourself... If you could do this with your life, same shit as Diddy. Same shit as Diddy, but on a minuscule scale. All right. I am worth billions of dollars. Billions of dollars. Billions of dollars. Why am I fucking around doing all this other shit? Is it a power thing? Can't be for Corey. He wasn't there. Your dad is Peter Guns. He's over here hosting a show called Cheaters, and he's a fucking cheater. That's fucking crazy. You got all this, all the tools to become something with yourself, and you choose not to be. You choose to be a criminal. Fucking crazy. J Electronica. J Electronica is one of my fucking favorite artists under Jay-Z. I don't know why he didn't do what he did. They call me J Electronica, J Elec Hamaka, J Elec Ramadan, Zamla, Natsamalika, knocking off the Yarmulkes. Yeah, he's a 5%. He's definitely knocking off Yarmulkes. Chose not to do nothing. Stunning for Vega. I just mentioned him. He's on the other list. Don't know who the hell he is. I didn't even know he was with the baby. All right. Zedzilla. That looks like Yo Gotti. I think that's Yo Gotti's artist. Never heard of him. 50 Cent and Spider Low. I remember when 50 Cent was pushing Spider Low. They had his mixtapes all over the hood. It wasn't that good. I'm sorry. Sorry. If you're Mr. Loke, it's just an opinion. All right. You don't have to do anything if you ever run into me. All right, Mr. Loke, thank you very much. What else did they say about him? He just signed anyway. Because he signed Hot Rod. Hot Rod was terrible, and he tried to sign Messiah. Messiah was terrible. Sabine, you remember Messiah? I showed you that mixtape about Messiah, and it was the worst thing ever. It was the worst thing ever. God, I hope he's fucking bagging groceries. All right, Chip the Ripper. That's Kid Cudi's artist. Yeah, never heard of his shit. Yellow Wolf. Yellow Wolf is Eminem's. All right. My bad. Just got a message. Yellow Wolf. Put these. Get them back. The pickup with the hiccups. And then, yeah. No. Yeah. We're good. We're good. I wasn't running for your music, sir. I'm good. And I would expect that from Eminem. I would. He would pick Yellow Wolf to be his protege. Not Obi Trice. Obi Trice dropped this shit too. What the fuck? Obi Trice, what the fuck did you do, man? You just threw away your career. All right. Murphy Lee, biggest blunder ever. Mr. Murphy Lee, biggest. He actually was there. He had hits. He had songs. He dropped an album. He was one of the best artists on the St. Lunatics. That's squandered talent right there. I don't know if he's even trying to continue to make music, but Murphy Lee... Come on, give me two pairs. I need two pairs. First one. Yeah, he won a Grammy, That's crazy. And still, nobody knows who the fuck he is to this day. And what I mean by that is the new generation. All right, Dr. Dre, Hitman. Don't know who the fuck that is. All right, I'm going to keep going. Yeah, look at Obi Trice on the list. Diddy had King Los. I remember King Los. People were saying he was the next big thing. People were going, nah, it's King Los's time. When Control dropped, everybody was like, the best verse was King Los's. I would say it's Joel Ortiz. But that's what they were saying. King Los is it. King Los is going to have the streets in the chokehold. King Los, King Los, King Los. The only thing that had it in the chokehold was Diddy. Probably with that baby oil. I'm just playing, sir. I'm just playing. Jokey. It's a joke.
It's dead.
Don't hurt me. Because I think he's from Brooklyn or Harlem. He's from one of those places with an arm. All right. Jin. Swizz Beatz was promoting the hell out of Jin, but then he found religion. So I can't really talk on that. But he wasn't that good either. Oh, look at Hot Rod. Hot Rod just came up. Terrible. Jay-Z again just came up. Yeah, it's mostly New York artists that fucking back up people. So Jay-Z... had one. He did have one. True Life. True Life was one of my favorite up-and-coming New York artists because as much as I love Jim Jones, love his music, listen to his shit all the time. every day. True Life was kicking his ass. True Life was, because he used to run with Jim Jones. He used to do security for Jim Jones. He would handle shit for Jim Jones. They had a fallout. And the person you don't want to go to war with is the person that you call to do your dirt. The person that you told to go do this. That's the person you didn't want to have a problem with. So every time Jim Jones would be at a New York function, True Life's like, I'm going to go ruin his fucking day. So it'll be crazy because they're like, all right, there goes Jim Jones. I don't like the way that sounds. That's better. There goes Jim Jones. Every time beef happened, True Life was there to go get him. Anytime Jim Jones had beef, True Life was like, hey, man, hey, it's me again. Shit. So it's like, all right. It wasn't like they were trying to be very...
very demure.
They weren't. They were getting real ugly, all right? And they went beyond...
Shorty's just talking shit.
Went way beyond that, all right? They were trying to go get shit popping, all right? Every time Life saw him, he threw a shell at him and he was like,
got that shit, huh?
Every time. Every time. So, yeah. True Life was something. And he made decent music. I liked his music. And he just, when he got signed, he went to jail. I think he did 10 years for a stabbing. So, stabbed the shit out of that person. But yeah, I think he went to jail for a stabbing. And yeah. That stopped his career from taking off, which is the way the cookie crumbles. Like, if you're always out there looking for beef, drama, shit catches up to you, unfortunately. No, not unfortunately, fuck that. Catches up, man. The fuck you want. But, yeah. I think that's all that I have for the Ask Me a Question section. Time to move on. On to the next one. On to the next one. On to the next one. Freeze. Boom, 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 boom. My shit's off. Somebody go and get some money, please. All right, guys. Let's see what we got next on the docket. And I'm back again. Yo, this has been the most difficult episode for me to record. Like, I kept having to stop. And thank God we're in the last two portions of the show. Because I've been trying to record this episode since 2 o'clock in the morning. Got up at 8 o'clock in the morning, had to leave. It is now 12:41 p.m. A.M., whatever, p.m. Highly annoyed. Hopefully, this is a decent episode I'm putting out, because I'm going to be mad when I review this later. And it's not where I want it to be. So without further ado, let's go and hit the button I always hit by accident. Welcome, 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 welcome to Part-Time Lover. This is a section that most people fast forward to because they like the drama. And sometimes it's a lot. You should see the ones I don't post. But yeah, man. Part-Time Lover is a section where people bring their relationship issues to the forefront and they ask us for our, well, they ask me for my opinion to see if it aligns with theirs or to give insight from a different perspective. So that is the point of Part-Time Lover. Wait, did I jump the gun? I jumped the gun. We are not in Part-Time Lover. Look at me. Look at me, look at me, look at me, look at me. All right. Yeah, I jumped the gun. Back to the...
Wait, Jose! Jose, I got to tell you something!
Back to that, people. So, the section that I left out was, I got asked, what are my thoughts on the Met Gala that's coming up next year? The theme is, do I have it saved? Is super fine tailoring black style. I don't think you guys understand what you guys are setting yourself up for. Whoever thought that theme was going to be a good theme for the Met Gala, that is mostly not us. This shall be a fucking blast, and I can't wait.
It's dead, it's dead.
Y'all want to see how many ways they could do blackface without coloring themselves? This is it. This is it. Everybody's going to show up to the damn Met Gala dressed as Jonathan Majors dancing in that fucking video. It is going to be crazy. They're going to be dressed like, if only they would. Oh, they're going to dress like fucking Dave Chappelle at the Player Hater Convention. Watch. You guys are wilding out for choosing that as a theme. Who thought that was a theme to go with? They're going to dress like us in the year 2000 with the baggy jeans and the oversized t-shirts and the jersey for no reason. Watch. You're asking for a lot. What are my thoughts? It is a fucking mistake. Somebody's going to go there dressed like Kanye West and wear baggy clothes, a garbage bag, and a fucking shiesty over their head. Or what's that shit called? Leg stockings. Yeah. We are in tune and in stored for something that's going to be a fucking mess. We'll leave it to somebody that's gonna dress like the two girls that Sean and Marlon dressed up as in White Chicks. You better believe that's gonna happen, and I don't want to hear no goddamn complaining when that happens. All right it's gonna be a mess. All right, they're gonna bring back baby fat. Yo, what the fuck, Instagram, stop messing with my shit. They're going to bring back baby fat. They're going to bring back Fat Farm. They're going to bring back Iniche, a.k.a. NYC. They're going to bring back all these things. Oh, my God. I could see myself thinking back, strolling down memory lane. They're going to come through with the belts, with the little words that shoot across. Not the original ones with the bedazzled name. No. They're going to bring back like the little corner store bodega signs, like open lotto. Watch. It's going to be a fucking mess, yo. That shit's going to be. They're all going to show up like Robert Downey Jr. in Tropic Thunder. Watch. I'm the guy playing the guy that's playing another guy. Like, it's a fucking mess. Remember when the politicians dressed up in African garb to salute black people? You better expect that shit. That's exactly what's going to happen. A whole bunch of pandering. Kamala's going to wear her finest of, let me shut up. But, yeah. Like, let me see your grills. Let me see your what? Yep, your grills. Yep, your grills. It's going to be some shit, bro. Why would they do that? Why are they? The only person that's gonna really thrive in this is Kim Kardashian. That's it. That's the only person that's gonna thrive. She was like, if anybody knows how to run with somebody else's style, it's her. But yeah, whoever thought about that, this might be your last year. This might be your last year. I don't think you know what you just set yourself up for, because no matter how you tailor it, you cannot overlook the blunders that people are going to think like, oh, that's culturally accurate. Maybe you shouldn't, but let's see. That's going to be a fucking mess. I don't know what they're going to do with that. They're going to have fun with that at our expense. Not my expense. I'm going to be laughing my ass off at that shit, but let's see how that goes. That's going to be Juicy Couture. They're going to bring that shit back. Is Juicy still a thing? Baby fat. Nelly announced he's bringing back apple bottom jeans right on time. All right. They're about to book Flo Rida for that night. Flo Rida is the king of that wave. Shit. Apple bottom jeans with the boots and the fur and the whole room looking at her here. She hit the flow and go low, 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 low. Apple bottom jeans with the boots and the fur, the whole thing looking at her.
She hit the flow.
Baby go
low, 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 low.
Apple bottom jeans.
Boots with the furs.
The whole club was looking at her.
She hit the flow.
Shawty go
low,
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 low, low, low.
All right, stop fucking around. All right, now we could go to Part-Time Lover. Welcome. I'm not going to redo the whole intro again because I already said it. All right. So if you know, you know. All right. So what's the first question we're going to jump into? Siri, 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 I need you.
Man, I thought I caught one. Got me a cougar. I was over here thinking it was gonna be fun and getting paid, but nah, she's just giving me laters and laying me the fuck out. How can I break this off without giving up my things?
Man up, you little bitch.
Oh boy, over the top.
How outre.
You thought who was chump? You thought cougars were chump? Are you crazy? That's how I know you're young. Because you're not well experienced in that verse. You're not experienced in that multiverse, all right? See, cougars are...
You know the fucking vibes?
If you have a high sex drive, then you get a cougar, all right? If you have a high sex drive, you get a cougar. For whatever reason, due to genetics...
It's not right.
Girls get extra hornier. Girls get extra... over the top with it. They want more. I think that's the real reason for divorce rates when they get older. But girls just somehow get hornier as they get older. Well, how do you know? I work in an office, speaking from experience. My youngest girl cannot... Wait, that sound right. Oh, no Drake, no Drake, no Drake. No Diddy, no Diddy, no Diddy. The of age youngest girl in the office cannot fuck with the sex drive of the 50-year-old women in the office. It's just true. It's just absolutely fact. And these little heifers are, they're nasty. They ain't afraid to do shit. They be,
Lord have mercy, I'm about to
when
bust.
When they took it back, I be like,
God, no!
When they take out their teeth, Holy shit. Like, wait, hold on. Where are that? When they take off their teeth.
I'm trying to get see what that be like. Like that. Look, be like that.
Fucking Stark. Fucking Suckstar the leaf blower. They're fucking crazy, son. The grip. You ever had two nubs on you?
I'm trying to get see what that be like. Like that. Look, be like that.
I know. But when they get a hold of you, I'd be like,
Help me.
That shit is crazy, son. You got an older joint. See, you thought you was going to knock some old shit down and they were going to buy you shit. No. That's a very select few that get worn out that crazy. No. Some of them, assassins, killers, they already snatched enough souls. If they were in the army, they would have all the goddamn medals on one side of their fucking shoulder. Like, older girls, a lot of the times, they are fucking killers. They are snipers. It's a problem. So if you're not built like that, don't get yourself one. Because the last one that I had, she was on demon time. Demon time from when I would walk into the building, like on me, trying to molest me. I'm pretty sure this is a Me Too moment, but yeah. Kind of the way that Elon Musk robots are going to get molested. All right. It's going to be an R2-D2 moment over there. Me too. But yeah. No. Sir, you were misinformed. You were, for lack of a better word.
No!
We're tricked.
You cannot trick me.
That's not you.
You cannot trick me.
You were tricked into thinking that they were chump. And she saw your goofy ass and she was like,
okay, let's go.
Nah, son. Nah. They be about that life. They be ready to ground and pound you like a fucking UFC fighter. No. You know what it's like? It's like when you get a thick chick, right? You get a thick chick. I know I'm losing my lady followers right now. And you're like, she could probably take a pounding. Like, she's built for comfort, not speed, right? And then They can't take it. It's like, oh, God. But then you find yourself a little skinny joint, and they're built for speed, not comfort. They are there to ruin your life. That's what they're there for. That little skinny thing, is not letting go of you. All right. Even when you try to like pull off, no. Them skinny joints, they're an issue. All right. You're in the same dangerous territory. These older women, high sex drives, Yeah. The only good thing is sometimes you can't get them knocked up because they already hit their season. But That was a lot. Hold on, let me see. One wrote, I didn't get to fully write it out, but let me just play it. Because it's very straight to the point. And he wrote like a lot of shit. And I feel bad for him.
She wants me to role play as one of her coworkers.
That is.
Wait, Jose!
I can't. It's 50-50. It's good and bad. Because it's good that she's telling you what she wants, how she wants to be satisfied. It doesn't make you a... It doesn't. Because the flip side to that is she could just be fucking the coworker. See, 50-50. It hurts your ego, but it really shouldn't because she's giving you the wherewithal to be like, hey, I want this from you, but I don't want you to act like you. I know a lot of guys can't do it. A lot of guys feel away. Depends how comfortable you are in your own skin. Because if my girl to be like, hey, man, I want you to act like President Barack Obama. Yes, we can. A change will come. Like, all that shit is happening, all right? I don't care. Because as long as she's not going out there and doing the actual act, that's good enough for me, all right? Because up here, you can't control what your partner wants to think. Your partner wants to think some crazy shit, go ahead, let them. But it's the fact that they're not acting on it, which makes it a better thing. Because when they start acting on it, then you got to be like, all right, I'm probably going to go to jail. A lot of guys don't have the wherewithal to be like, well, it's her fault. They're going to take it on the other person. A lot of people, not just guys, people. So, yeah. That's a crazy thing. I want you to act like somebody else. What do you mean? How do they act? I'm like, oh, you know, I just don't want you. I just want you to get home and don't load the printer with paper. Oh, yeah, that's bad. Don't put the cap back on the pen. Oh, you nasty. Don't fully press on the stapler so it gets stuck halfway in, halfway out. I know.
Holy mother of God!
Gets me going every time, all the time. I don't think that's like the worst thing in the world. I don't think so. I think it could be it could be way more worse than what you think. I think it could be detrimental to your health and your ego if your girl starts fucking the guy from the copy room, all right? Those are just my thoughts, all right? So that's all I got for part-time lover. Hopefully, I did a decent job for you guys.
Part-time lover!
Now, I'm going to get out of here. I'm going to cut it short because I don't know how many more distractions I'm going to get so far. So before I leave, I just want to say shout out to you guys out there reaching your goals, doing your thing. All right. Keep fighting. Keep hustling. Don't let things deter you from what you're doing. Every day's a fight. It's up to you if you're going to keep going. And if you get knocked down, get your punk ass up. In the wise words of Meek Mill. All right. You got to. All right. Don't let them see you on the ground, all right? Keep pushing, all right? It's a long-ass supply, all right? So I just want to wish everybody out there the best. Thank you for continuing to support me. Welcome to all the newcomers. Goodbye to the people that are unsubscribing, all right? But you guys are all appreciated. Shout out to the new viewers on YouTube, all right? So the numbers on YouTube started going up, and I want to say thank you. Thank you. Thank you. That's still going? Good. Yeah, thank you, because it is my goal to get these subs up and these views up. So for YouTube, because we're doing amazing on Spotify. I just want to throw that in y'all faces. We're doing great on Spotify, all right? But the YouTube could be better, and it is getting better, and thank you, all right? So please continue to like, comment, share, and subscribe. I am your host.
On my cool, Jay.
A.K.A.
On my cool, Jay.
Jose. Oh, wait. A.K.A.
Wait, Jose!
And I am out of here. Peace out.